Very important email coming up here, so let's get started. This might be the most important video you watch on my channel. For those of you who've never been on my channel before, my name is Steve Houston, and on this channel, we talk all things financial services. We talk about the products, we talk about the IMOs, we compare the IMOs, we compare all the different compensation plans. We talk about growing ourselves so we're better equipped to take full advantage of the industry that we're in, which is mortgage cession and final expense. And the standard is always, I supply third-party documentation to back up my opinions and my rhetoric. Third-party documentation is better than any conversation, right? So this week, I want to discuss an email that I got last week while I was traveling, dated January 20th of 2019. So the email went kind of like this. It says, I'm not going to mention any IMO names, but it says, I was formerly with so-and-so and so-and-so in 2015. Then I found another IMO so-and-so, and I was there until 2017. I had left them and finding out it was not the right IMO for me. And around 2017, I was introduced to my current IMO. I am buying leads through the OPT system, also from an outside source. I don't know what it is. People don't pick up the phone is the biggest problem. If they do, they say they never fill out the form and don't call me. I mostly buy B leads and some A leads. I had purchased 25 final expense internet leads, which is a very bad mistake from a different source. If I purchased 15 leads mixed A and B, spending about $400, I might get 2 appointments. The ones that do pick up, I usually set an appointment. I am using so-and-so's script, but making it my own words. There's no plan B for me. I do another business on the side, which I work part-time, but my goal is to do the insurance work full-time. I spoke to so many people, and I'm looking for an answer. Hope you can help. So that was the email I received earlier this week. So look, there's a lot to unpack there. Let's begin. First, I don't know what it is, but people just don't pick up the phone. It's just the way it is, right? I mean, I don't answer phones that I don't recognize the phone number. It's normal. Get numb to the process of this business. At the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. We have agents making high six figures, and guess what? They had the same exact issue. People don't pick up the phones for them either. So that part of it is not unusual. It's normal. That's why I always say it's a law of large numbers. You have to have quantity so you can start to create some momentum through some appointment setting and go and run some appointments and ultimately make some sales. And then everything starts to fall in place because you're cash flowing your business. But there are some things that you might want to check. First, are you using your cell phone? Big no-no. I don't use my cell phone to make dials. There's many, many reasons for that. Number one, it's too easy to break up with somebody on the phone or on text, right? I don't text my clients. I don't email my clients. I use a Ring Central line. I have an app for my cell phone. And so when no matter where I'm at, I can receive calls on my cell phone with a different business number. And when I'm making dials, I'm calling out in that same number, because I don't want the ability to text, and I don't want them to be able to text me to cancel my appointment. So you can try Google Voice, you can try Ring Central, you can try Vonage, kind of mix it up, right? But get the app for your phone and dial out from that. Why is that important? Look, if you're dialing from a business line or a cell phone, ultimately they can block you. But the bottom line is they're not going to call you back. It's a rarity for them to call you back. But by leaving a voicemail, you are now identifying yourself as to who you are and what your intention is, and now they can block your phone number. You don't want that. You want a chance to speak to them on the phone so you can explain to them that you're not a telemarketer, that they actually requested this information, rather than listening to a voicemail and have them make assumptions based on your voicemail. Or maybe they've changed their mind. I still want to have that one-on-one conversation with them on the phone. The next objection this gentleman was saying he was getting is they never filled it out. Well, if you're doing direct mail leads, we know that's not true because you have a piece of paper with their handwriting on it. This is where your phone script that you're using comes in to be a very, very big deal. But the script I use says I'm verifying the information that you supplied. So they can't say they didn't fill it out. Now, they may not have filled it out, and this happens a lot. Maybe the spouse filled it out, which is about 90% of the cases. The spouse usually fills out the form because they feel most in jeopardy if the other spouse passes away. And that happens. So they may be honest with you and saying they didn't fill it out. The spouse may have, which is why you say maybe your wife did or maybe your partner did. You begin to immediately verify the information. Mr. Jones, I have you down here. Your birth date is 5/21/1962. You're 150 pounds and your mortgage is Bank of America for 363. So by doing that, they know that you've got that information from somewhere. If they still push back on it, That's one where I would put aside, maybe call back in a couple of weeks later if you're still getting that same objection. So my next move then would be to put it in my briefcase, and when I'm in the area, go up, and I do this quite a bit actually, go knock on the door, put a face with the form, and say, here, we talked on the phone, this is what you filled out, this is what I'm calling you about so that I can give you some of your options. Now they can see the form and it kind of triggers their memory. The next one says is don't call me. Well, it is what it is. You paid for the lead. I would put it back in your sack and call it again in a few weeks. Life insurance is an emotion-based decision, right? Meaning something happened to get them to fill out the form in the first place, and that very thing may happen again, and they'll be more receptive the next time around. Maybe it's someone in their office, maybe it's a family member got sick, passed away, and it kind of jolted them about their mortality, and they don't feel quite as vulnerable as they did maybe a few weeks ago, right? This happens a lot when you're working the bonus leads, older leads. If you're working the brand new fresh leads, you don't get it nearly as often. But remember, this is a law of large numbers business. You succeed in quantity, not just quality. The more leads you have, the more chances you have to get some appointments and build some momentum. The next comment he says is I mostly buy some B leads and some A leads. Well, that's perfect. That's exactly what I do. As long as your B leads and A leads are coming from a source that you can trust, that haven't been resold, redated, recycled, you know, sold multiple times by an IMO that's trying to make money off their lead program, or from a third-party source who's absolutely in the business to make money off the leads, right? So as long as that's not happening, that's exactly what I recommend. But you have to do this weekly, not work what you have until the prospect and you are beat down. You gotta be getting fresh new leads every week. Now fresh, I mean fresh to you. They could be aged leads or bonus leads, but you need a free batch every week. He commented on that email that he got about 2 appointments out of $400. That's not great. Massive room for improvement. That's not normal, right? If you're working bonus leads, it's about 16 to 1 on leads that are maybe 6 months to a year old, maybe 10 to 1 on leads that are maybe a few weeks old, and maybe 2 to 1 on your fresh leads. That's about normal. So the ratio that he's getting is not good. But even at that ratio, if he got 2 appointments and the average closing ratio is about 50%, that means he's going to go on 2 appointments, close 1 sale. Even at a 70% contract, that's about $800. Next day in your bank account, about $600 thereabouts. So you are profitable and you have not lost any money. It is very dangerous to be running $400 for 2 appointments. In order to be profitable, it kind of requires you to be running at about a 50% closing ratio, and not everybody does that initially. There is room for improvement, but you're not bankrupting yourself out of business. You need to make some drastic changes very quickly. But let's celebrate the fact that you are getting appointments on some very old leads that may not be very good in terms of quality. So while it's dangerous and you need to make corrections as soon as possible, but you are learning. You have to be willing to learn how to work these leads and be bad before you're good. He goes on to say he's using his IMO phone script, but here it comes. Now, I think this is the biggest problem in the email. He says, I'm making it my own words. Danger sign, right? I say over and over again, no tweaking. No tweaking. Don't tweak a proven system. If you're following a script that you know produces appointments, not from a so-called coach, we have a lot of in this industry that has never used a script, has never put their name on an application, never sold anything, but he took the script they got from the IMO, doesn't really know for whether or not it really works, and gave it to you. Now, I get that. That's an issue. But if it's a time-tested and proven script that works, don't change anything. Force yourself to follow it word for word. No tweaking until you become successful. Then if you want to put it in your own words and you mess things up, you screw it up, and you start, you know, your closing ratio goes way down and you're not booking appointments, you're back to where you were before, you can go back to when you were successful using the script that they gave you word for word. So I challenge you to practice over and over and over and over again to learn the script exactly the way it was. Most likely, the script was designed after years of effort and it works. Maybe not, but that's what you need to determine. The best way I can explain to you why this is so dangerous is if you buy a McDonald's franchise and you call the home office and say, hey, listen, I've changed the blueprints. I'm going to put the French fry machine by the soda machine on the other side of the building. You would no longer own a McDonald's franchise, right? They would say, no, you're not going to change a proven system. And that's what I'm saying. Now, again, the disclaimer to all that is you have to make sure you have or working a proven system. Now, you can verify that by looking at the leaderboard at your IMO, or more importantly, look at agents inside of your agency. The last comment the person made was, there is no plan B for me. I'm looking for help. Exactly. I mean, I've been talking about no plan B for years. Plan B is what this generation was sold as a smart business practice, and it's complete BS, right? If you have a plan B, you have admitted that you might fail or are expecting to fail, and therefore you've come up with this plan B option, right? But here's the thing. The thing I say almost every video is the surest way not to fail is to be determined to succeed. And if you're determined to succeed, you cannot fail. So what's the point of a plan B except telling yourself that, hey, self, I may not make it. So I'm going to have this plan B over here. Just in case I fall, I can fall into this one, right? And so you've already admitted that failing is a possibility. And that's bad news for you telling yourself that I might fail or I'm expecting to fail. Therefore, I'm investing my time into this plan. But you got to burn all bridges and decide this is the industry that you want to be in and not have any plan Bs. The plan B mentality burns so many dreams of so many people every single day because they don't burn the bridges. They stick their toe in it and try it and see if it's going to work, or I hope it will, and they're smoking opium, right? Here's the facts. If you're committed to success, then you will succeed. Because if you're determined to succeed, you've already told yourself you cannot fail. So find a coach, someone that can teach you this business day to day, not book knowledge, but from their proven success, and follow what he or she says exactly until you learn the skills needed to succeed in this industry. And from there, you can build a work-life balance and a skill set that you can use your entire life to earn six figures minimum part-time and multiple six figures full-time. I hope that makes sense. Leads are a big part of this business. I'm going to continue with a few more videos on leads. I would encourage you to go watch the Law of Large Numbers video and also the Beef Patties and Mortgage Section videos and get more information, because you've got to fix your expectations and the 6 inches of brain matter between your ears. If you don't and your expectations are off, it can take you out of this business. So make sure you know what to expect. Follow the Law of Large Numbers and you give yourself the best chance of success. So I hope you enjoyed me sharing that email with you. I get a lot of those kind of emails. I'll do more of this as we go forward. I appreciate you being here on this video. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, click the subscribe button. There's a bell right next to the subscribe button. If you mash that bell, you'll get instant notifications when these videos go up and any live streams. And do me a favor and like the video if you got something out of the content today. I would appreciate that. And make a comment below. I love reading the comments, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Right? Go out there, man. Be a warrior for yourself and for your family and for your future. Don't just stick your foot in this thing. Be a warrior. Be willing to fight and be a soldier for your own success in the greatest industry on the planet. Bye-bye.